Boom! What's going on? So, I'm going to show you how you can use workouts around your cheat meals so you can burn fat and make sure that this is going this way and not that way. So the first thing you're going to do is you have to earn your cheat. We call this the ignition workout. And good news is you're not going to sweat a bunch, so you can actually do this if you were going out to eat or if you were at a party. And you can do this close as possible to your cheat meal or your cheat time period. It can be before or after, but you want it close. So we don't want to do this in the morning and then when you're going to cheat in the afternoon. We want to do this right next, before or after that time period. What we're going to be doing is isometric contractions. So one of those is going to be a wall sit. So you want to get the feet up under you, 90 degrees. Get in a position where your legs are shaking. If you're advanced on exercising, you can hold a weight and just add a bunch of weight here. You want to be shaking, especially that last 30 seconds should be very difficult. Now you only have to do that one time, so that's the good news. And then you're going to go into a push-up hold. This is going to be very difficult for 90 seconds. You want the elbows at a 90 degree bend, so you're in the lower part of the movement. If that's too tough, where you can go on the knees. A lot of people will still even have problems with that. So what you would do in place of that is lean into the wall, get here, and you will push the wall as hard as you can. Now it's easy just to lean against it, so don't get lazy there. Make sure you're actually pushing as hard as you can, and you're getting that shaking going on for 90 seconds. And the last one is a plank. Obviously, you can add some weight on your lower back if you need to make that more advanced. Now the reason why we're doing it this way, doing these isometric holds, is when we do that and you have the cheat meal, it tells your muscles, your body, it needs to store glycogen in your muscles. So you're a lot less likely to have fat spill over, or those carbohydrates being stored as fat. They get stored as glycogen in your muscles when we do the isometric hold. So that's the reason for that. Now once you do that, remember it's 90 seconds each exercise, one set, very close during the time. You gotta earn your cheat. Then you're gonna go into a cheat meal or cheat time period. You can do this for 4 to 6 hours. Eat whatever you want. Obviously, you can't get stupid and like have chocolate-covered fried turkey with butter and, you know, extra sour cream on it. I mean, you can't go crazy. So you can have some pizza, but let's do two slices instead of the entire pizza. So you can have what you want. You do need to have a higher calorie intake that day. So don't try and like skip some of the calories and just put them all into one meal. You need to be eating at least 500 more calories than you do on your normal dieting days when you're doing your cheat meal or your cheat meal day. After you do your cheat meal, you're gonna fast for 16 hours. So whenever the last thing that you did was, you don't eat the next day until 16 hours. And then right before you break that fast, you are gonna do what's called a depletion workout. It starts off very intense, and then you keep the heart rate up for another 20 minutes after you do that intense exercise. So what I have listed for you here is you got 10 burpees, 100 yard sprint. You'll walk back, 10 burpees, 100 yard sprint. You do that 4 times. And then after you do that intense routine, you'll just keep your heart rate up by walking, jogging. You can do some agility work, some core work. Just stay in uncomfortable, keep your heart rate up for another 20 minutes. And so the depletion workout is you have to burn your cheat. So do the ignition right when you're doing the cheat meal to earn your cheat. You do the cheat meal, have fun with that, enjoy it. Then we fast for 16 hours. Right after that fast to break it, you do the depletion workout. You burn your cheat meal, and then you get right back on track with your nutrition plan.